You're the keeper of the flame, the spirit of our hopes and dreams.
And now it's time to run. You're the keeper of the flame, the spirit of our inner pride. And now it's time to run. Time to run.
Ch7 and Prime, bringing you the Sydney 2000 Olympics.
Kathy Freeman turns water into flame as the games of the 27th Olympiad begin.
With Jennifer Adams, this is 7 News.
Good evening. 7 years after Australia won the Olympic Games, the dreams become a reality. We've just witnessed a breathtaking opening ceremony watched by more than 100,000 people inside Stadium Australia and televised to 3.7 billion people around the world. And as the Games begin, so one of this country's best-kept secrets has been revealed. We now know who lit the cauldron. Herb Elliott carried it into the stadium where Australia's legendary female athletes took over. The honour of lighting the cauldron falling to our great gold medal hope, Kathy Freeman. The lighting of the cauldron was the much-anticipated highlight of what has been a wonderful tribute to our cultural and sporting heritage.
With a crack of the whip from the man from Snowy River, the most anticipated event in our history was underway. Australia was saying g'day to the world. Stadium Australia was turned into a giant fishbowl. The wonders of our oceans floating past. The first inhabitants cleansing this meeting place as they welcomed billions to their land. Out of bushfires came the spectacular Australian landscape. Captain Cook and even hundreds of Ned Kellys made an appearance, but this was more than a history lesson. This was showing off our culture, the things that make all of us Australians. Our unique love affair with corrugated iron, rainwater tanks, the wool shed, and then the arrival of people from all over the world.
From the four corners of the globe, from Africa, from Asia, the Americas, from Europe.
The star of this show was 13-year-old Nikki Webster.
But if you would take us with you, then we have already won.
It was a whirl of wonderment, almost too much to take in. Hundreds of tap dancers. 2,000 band members, the world's largest. Seeing this, it's hard to believe their part was ever in doubt. The Olympics seemed an eternity getting here. The 110,000 strong crowd was going to enjoy every second. then came the real stars of 27th Olympics, the athletes.
And as always, the Greeks will be first.
Almost 11,000 in all, from the smallest of teams from countries few would recognise to the superpowers.
People's Republic of China.
China's ranks already reduced by drug scandal. Many teams leave behind countries in turmoil.
If ever a country was searching for gold, it is Fiji.
The Olympics uniting all religions and cultures as only it can, even old enemies.
This is one of the unforgettable moments in sport. Athletes from South Korea and the People's Democratic Republic of Korea together as one.
These men and women marched as independent athletes, but all of the world knows who they are.
Listen to the roar for the athletes from East Timor.
But the crowd was waiting for just one name.
Australia.
Basketballer Andrew Gaze, the proudest man in a proud country.
Everybody in the stadium has stood.
520 marched in bright new colours. It's our biggest team about to face their greatest challenge.
Good day, Sydney. Good day, Australia. Yes, the Olympic Games are back down under.
A television audience of 3.6 billion people, more than half the world's population, watched Australia tonight. They couldn't help but be impressed by what they saw. Mike Amor, 7 News.
A spectacular night, for many a once-in-a-lifetime experience, and no doubt there's plenty to talk about as they file out of Stadium Australia and into Olympic Park. Right now, more than 100,000 people are making their way to hundreds of buses and trains running out of Homebush Bay. And many will be heading into the city to continue the party at one of the Olympic live venues. 7 reporter Rani Sadler is at Martin Place. Rani, the crowd there has been watching the opening ceremony on the big screen. What's the verdict?
People here are just so proud. They're so proud tonight. They're so excited to be here. As you can hear, when the torch entered the stadium, people just went crazy, just like they are now. When the Australian team entered, there was clapping, there was cheering. People were hugging strangers. When Cathy Freeman got hold of the torch, the cheers were just deafening. People obviously approved of the choice.
And where else did people watch the opening ceremony?
People have gathered at Darling Harbour. They're watching the opening ceremony on the big screen. They also blocked off Church Street Mall in Parramatta, where I think they really enjoyed watching the opening ceremony.
And of course, many chose to throw a party at home.
Well, that's right. Lots of people stayed home to watch it. One party at Warunga was a toga party, where they Olympic cocktails, and they also made little name tags just of their own to show who they were.
Thanks, Rani. You look like you're having a pretty wild time out there. I'll leave you to it.
Thanks, Jen.
So tonight, the Olympic flame is burning bright high above Stadium Australia. It left Uluru 100 days ago, spending the final hours of its cross-country odyssey taking in Sydney's best-known landmarks.
The last of 100 days, but the big send-off from Town Hall didn't go quite as planned. A wrong turn for Deputy Lord Mayor Lucy Turnbull and no flame. A 5-minute wait with the family dog and she was off. Through the heart of the Olympic City. A date with the famous coat hanger was next, one of the most spectacular sights of the relay. Then to the man.